everyone for some more of my Westerlo career mode for FIFA 22. And we are ready to be beginning the Jupiler League campaign here with this home game against Circle Bruges. Which, we'll take a look at the table here real quick. You see, there was a game already played, Genk winning 3-0, and that was against Standard Liège. Wow. I didn't expect that, but anyway, you can see all 18 teams here that are in the league. But before we continue on, hopefully you guys have an awesome day today. Hope you guys are doing well. And one thing I wanted to say last video that I couldn't remember what I wanted to say is, of course, I won't be seeing this until much later, at least the comments to this video until much later. But you guys are probably wondering, well, Teddy, if Westerlo is in FIFA 23, why don't you just do a career mode on there? And for those of you that may or may not know, I've already made the decision that I'm not going to get FIFA 23, at least for career mode. If anything, I'm going to get it just for World Cup mode. But even then, I'm not sure what version I want to get. And to be honest with you, I'm thinking about getting the Switch version. And yes, I know it's the same thing every year, but at the same time, at least I know what I'm getting and it's consistent. Whereas if you get like the PlayStation or Xbox versions, it seems like career mode is getting worse and worse and worse. So if I do get FIFA 23 for World Cup mode, it will probably most likely be for the Switch. But I don't know yet. But yeah, I definitely won't be getting it for career mode, that's for sure. I know I've already created a rant video about career mode in FIFA 23. I don't want to go there. I don't want to get in a bad mood, but anyway, we get a Van Gerwt is out on loan. Simmons loan offer for a 1-year loan deal. We are going to go ahead and accept that. Hopefully, he'll get some game time over at loans. Halil Akbunar wants to play against Circle Bruges, which I'm going to tell him I'll think about it, but I certainly am, at least. Since Circle Bruges is going to be, no offense to them, the weakest opponent we're going to play in this video, he and the rest of the backups, 11, will get this game against Circle Bruges. And I do want to play my first team against both Ghent and Union Saint-Gilloise. And then beginning the next video will be Standard Liège and Club Bruges, and in this game against Charleroi. But just to make sure I do have my backup team here, which I do. You can see Voters and Lauvers and Akbunar. Metchula will be in there. Verdonk, the high-rated goalkeeper, will get a start here. So, without further ado, we're going to get into this game against Circle Bruges. And those are some really snazzy kits. Of course, they're in the traditional dark green and black kits. I'm going to go ahead and put those on them. Clear skies at the head, Kuipje, however you pronounce it. So without further ado, we're going to get into this match. Hoping we can get off to a decent start here with our backup team. You can see Eden Voters is our main striker for this game. He is a backup striker overall to Raul de Tomas. See, Akbunar scored 3 goals in his last 3 games. He will be getting the start here. And we get to see our home stadium for the first time here at the Het Kuipje. I believe that's how you pronounce that, but anyway, the Pro League begins. Both Circle Bruges and Westerlo walk out onto the pitch. Nice interception there. Was he onside? I think he was. That was too close to the goalkeeper right there. I should have just went forward with whoever got that ball. Why did I even attempt to try to keep that in? Hey, voters, I'm not going to do the same thing I did before. I'm going to go ahead. And Eden voters will get our first goal here in the regular season here in this career mode. Goal song that is. I don't remember. So we try to play the ball out. Nufa. Okay, ooh! Dang. The Schmeck. And Akbarner, the guy that wanted playtime at the beginning of this video, lets the fans know that he has arrived. Oh, I'm a believer. Okay. Or whatever. It's something believer. I forget what the name of the song is, but it's that one. Voters applying pressure. One of the worst slide tackles I've ever seen. Okay, DeSchmidt, nice first touch. I'm seeing Akbarner over there. What is that cross? But excellent pass right there. Good vision by Akbarner. Okay, that is, that's Lauvers, our center attacking mid. But I'm just gonna go ahead, I'm gonna go, jump to the result here. Hopefully we'll hang on. And we do get the clean sheet. Gibbadema came on for Everard, and Merino came on for Verhagen. But yeah, that's the kind of start I wanted for this particular season. Okay, Akbarner is very happy that he got game time. I'm gonna go ahead. And that was a great performance. I liked how he felt in that game and how he reacted. Simmons, I already responded to that. Lenny Adam, absolutely no way I am letting him go. He is my starting, one of my starting center mids alongside Merino. That's gonna be blocked. And John Janssens, I do plan on having him out on loan, though. Not a loan to buy, but direct Espanol one. Hopefully he'll want to go to Spain. But we are going to go ahead and press forward here. I don't want to go too far ahead. Should be a loan agreement. Oh, voters. Oh, Rami Ben Sabini for Eden Wouters. Wow. Voters. Ben Sabini. That. Normally I would jump at this. Let me see. I'm actually tempted by this. Let me look at the squad here real quick. Good. You know what? I think any other time I would take this deal, but I think I am going to block off this for voters, considering he is my main backup striker. We're going to go ahead and send my head here to this game against Ghent. Okay, Carlier loan offer. Simmons has been loaned out. Verdon transfer offer. Kachuk loan offer. And a loan agreement. Which, first of all, Verdonk going to Arsenal, there's no chance. He is my main backup goalkeeper. I am blocking that. Carlier, Valencia want him out on loan. Do I have him in my backup team? I don't know. I don't remember seeing his name. Yeah. He can go. Loan to buy from Alte. I'm going to delegate that to a one-year loan deal. And then Janssen's one-year loan to Espanyol. I'm going to go ahead and do that. And Carlier, one-year loan deal to Valencia. I'm going to go ahead and accept that. But anyway, we're going to play our first road game here, away game, against Ghent, one of the better teams in Belgium. And I am going to keep our away kits on, but I do want to see what Ghent's kits look like. I think I've already seen their kits before in a prior career mode, so... Oh, I am not playing in the rain. I just noticed that. I am not playing in the rain. I'll do overcast, but I won't do rain. But anyway, we're gonna go ahead and play this match. Inti Bao de Tomas, our starting striker. You can see Ghent Stadium. Well, it's the stadium they there. It's a generic stadium, but Ghent fans making it look pretty decent. As we kick things off here, Thorpe taking it along the left-hand side here. Okay, am I gonna get any support? Oh! Strike! Oh my god! Who is that? Oh, that was Mikel Merino. Who else? Our superstar center mid just absolutely letting that ball rip. Ghent unable to clear the ball and Merino punishes them for it. Look at that strike. I think I just found my thumbnail. Oh my god. Merino, take a bow. Wow. He couldn't have placed that any better in that bottom corner. Nice steal by De Tomas. De Tomas! I thought he was going to fluff that up, but... You see, he just goes by RDT on the back of his shirt. Whoa, what was that? Thorpe, are you gonna do anything, buddy? Or are you just gonna just flap around? Thorpe. Sanderson picking the ball up. And my own guy blocks it. That's one of my pet peeves in this game. Freaking get out of the way. I don't know who the hell you are, but you need to get out of the way. As our captain gets on the score sheet, I think that might have been De Tomas that blocked that from earlier. Ah, oh, that's one of my pet peeves. If you're one of my players and you see that one of your own teammates is making a shot, get the hell away. God, that's so stupid. This team's movement off the ball leaves a lot to be desired. And this team is just gonna march all the way to my freaking box, cause my guy can't freaking get the ball! Look at this! We're just letting them waltz to the freaking box, come on! Wakey wakey, guys! Thorpe, your crossing leaves a lot to be desired, and how the hell did you score that? Who is that? It's a good thing this team knows how to score belters, because so far this have very uneven performance. I gotta find out who that is. That is... I can't see the back of the shirt. Is that Caicedo? Yeah, it is. Okay, I'm just gonna jump to the result. I've pretty much seen enough. They do get a 2 goals back through Nurio and Bruno, which is not the same Bruno that plays for Newcastle. Okay, scouting report, which I'm not sending any scouts in this particular career mode. What, did he get a red card? Yeah, he did! Okay. We'll just put Lauvers in there, and then... Who else do we have? Guess we'll just do this. That way Lauvers can get some game time. Because he does have decent potential. What is his potential? Lauvers. Oh, he doesn't have much potential at all. Okay. He is 23 years of age, but hopefully he'll come good for us. As we're going to move forward to the game against Union Saint-Gilloise. That would actually be a pretty cool career mode to do for that team. Yance hasn't been loaned out. Curlier has been loaned out. Kachuk, loan agreement. 1 year loan spell at Altay. Hopefully he'll accept that. That's not too far from his homeland of Ukraine. Turkey, anyway. You know what I mean. Turkey isn't too far from Ukraine. But anyway, we are going to go ahead and sim to the game against Union Saint-Gilloise. But yeah, this is a team that very nearly... Well, they did make history by becoming the first newly promoted Belgian side to win the regular season, be on top of the regular season, but... Sadly for them, they ended up faltering in the championship round to eventual winners Club Brugge, but they, if I'm not mistaken, they are playing European football right now, so GG's to them. This is a team that has a lot of history. They were, especially at the beginning of the 20th century, Union Saint-Gilloise was the team in Belgium, but a lot of people don't realize that. They just feel this is just an up-and-coming hipster-type team, but they're really not. This is a team that's rich in history, but... Anyway, we're going to be playing under clear skies at the Het Kuipje. You can see their kits are... They're pretty much the same color scheme as we do. I'm just going to have them on, as the all-white for this game. You can see Saint-Gilloise playing a 3-1-4-2 formation. Very interesting with three at the back. But hopefully we can put in a much more consistent performance here in this game. So without further ado... And this will be the last game I feature in this video. And in the next video, we begin with tough games against Standard Liège and Club Brugge. And also game against Charleroi. And then hopefully by the end of the next episode, we'll be going towards our first Champions League game. Which I probably should show you that before I end this video. You see, Deo Tomas has scored 3 goals in his last 3 games. Both teams wearing blue and... They traditionally wear blue and yellow, but for this game, San Giorgio is playing in their all-white away kits, much like we have all-white away kits, so... guys, I'm telling you something right now. Thorpe feels incredibly awful off the ball. And he's not too great on the ball either, if I'm being honest. As Lauvers opens up the scoring here. And he was doing some kind of moonwalk there. I don't know what the hell that was, but... Lauvers getting on the score sheet. Casado! Nice first touch. Ah, that cross, though, leaves a lot to be desired. Crossing seems to be an issue with this team. I'm not really liking that so far. Ah! Heavy second touch. EA, why would you let... You know I was... I did not switch players there, I swear to God, I did not switch players, but the game switched players off me. Why would I switch- Caicedo! Both my wingers suck. I'm getting frustrated with this freaking team. I'm not even celebrating that. God, my wingers suck. My word, they can't cross and they freaking can't control the ball. This team just feels so weird off the ball. They really do. They almost feel kind of floppy. Thorpe! I swear to God, Thorpe! You are gonna freaking dropped! Thorpe, you are freaking useless. You had all that space to the left of the goalkeeper and the right of the goalkeeper, but you kicked it right at him like a stupid donkey. But anyways, Puertas does get a goal back from him. We are unable to keep the clean sheet, though. We do get the win. I hate raging. I really do. I'm not the kind of person that rages, but my God, this team feels awful right now. This team feels incredibly awful off the ball. And even on the ball, our wingers are lousy. At least our starting wingers. I don't think our backup ones were too bad. Aquinar was certainly sensational. De Schmidt was certainly good. I'm probably going to play my second team against Standard Liège, if I'm being honest. But my God, Thorpe, you are one of the worst wingers I've ever experienced. I mean, I'm not even... I'm just so frustrated right now. I really am. God. Hey, if he keeps playing like that, he's not going to get a whole lot of game time for me. I don't know what my transfer budget is, but I'm seriously considering letting him go. I really am. But I'm going to go ahead and just... No. Let him here. See if we get any more transfer offers before we end the video. What is our transfer budget? Oh, we still got 195. I might look to bring in a new winger. I really am. I don't know how much more I can handle Thorpe. Because he's certainly not getting the job done for me. He really is. I'm actually considering just replacing him right now. Maybe even Caicedo. I'll give Caicedo a little bit of a chance just because his finishing is pretty good. But Thorpe is awful. But I'll be looking at bringing somebody in because I do have the money to do so. But yeah, next time I'll see you guys, we will play this game against Standard Liège. We'll also play the game against Club Bruges, because that's going to be a huge game. And then we'll probably sim the games against both Charleroi and Santreden. And then we'll start our Champions League campaign against Frankfurt in the following video. As we're grouped with Arsenal and Marseille as well, so we're in a pretty tough group, so... But yeah, getting a new winger in is certainly going to be a priority for me, definitely. As Verhagen gets a loan offer, which I'm not even entertaining that because he's been pretty good for me. But yeah, next time I see you guys, we will most likely have a new starting winger because I think Thorpe is getting kicked out. But thank you guys so much for watching this. Hope you guys are enjoying the series so far. And I'll be seeing you guys again next time.